Hello students, welcome to this particular session, day 6 of your CA Inter, live revision session on income tax. Students, all of you just confirm once. Students, in fact, this was my third attempt to get the live today. Because of this incessant rain, we have got a temporary network connection. And that is the reason why today also when I came to live, I had to take this lecture, because obviously I am going with the targets to complete your revisionary session in a comprehensive manner. So a temporary arrangement, I have done it so that at least there is a continuity in my lecture without any break, because the break is something which I don't want it at first place. So students, this number is my number which I have just shared in the screen right now. In fact, in the last three attempts when I was doing to come live with you, I was just putting this number in front of you. So just you can take this number and only WhatsApp me if possible, if any this thing. Any case, I've told you that I'm going to make one group, but this is my number. Okay, so I will make a WhatsApp group or a Telegram group as we have discussed 2 days back. So this is one thing which I'll do it. Nishank, Ferry, Priya. In fact, Priya was in touch. Kuldeep, Nishank, Pramnant, Chandana, Trinath. So students, let's start with this now. I think everything is there. The things are live. In fact, by this 1 hour, 1.5 hours, I think you have SFM lecture also in the evening, isn't it? So we have approximately 1 hour at least, whatever we can do it in 1 hour. I'll just do it quickly. PGBP, at least that section that we were referring, I'm trying to going to complete, and I'll also get a confidence in the network, the temporary arrangement which I've done it. Hopefully by it, because obviously it was a weekend, we had weekend because these people are not working, but they have given me a temporary arrangement so that I can pursue with my lectures. So but tomorrow hopefully the things would be up and running. But if supposingly still there is a technical snag, at least this particular the temporary arrangement, I can just deal with it with all of you tomorrow also with this arrangement, if it is all going well. So this 1 hour would be very important for us. Do give me the feedback about the technical snag, if at all any in between. Just let me know, students, once, so that even I'll keep in mind this alternate arrangement which I'll have. So students, now then, we have done yesterday or day before yesterday the depreciation part, and only the last point which was there in the depreciation part, students, the last point was about the actual cost. But before I proceed on the actual cost, I had given you one particular question. If you can recall, I had given you one question, students, and that question was that the amalgamated company, remember that? The amalgamated company, that amalgamated company will be eligible for the depreciation. Thank you, Priya. Will be eligible for the depreciation. Remember that depreciation question which I was asking to you? The WDV. The WDV which will be there for the amalgamated company. What will be the WDV for the amalgamated company? Will it be the purchase consideration minus the depreciation availed by the amalgamated company as on the 1st of April? I think that was the question. Last lecture. That last point that we had, I told you that I'll ask you in the next class. So I had gave you two options. The opening WDV as on the 1st of April 2020, that is the next year, 1st April 2020, what would be the opening WDV for the amalgamated company in respect of those asset, in respect of what? Those asset that it has received from the amalgamation, what will be the opening WDV? Will it be the price which the amalgamated company has paid to the amalgamating company, and from that minus the depreciation which the amalgamated company has taken, or it will be the WDV of the amalgamating company minus the depreciation claimed by the amalgamated company as on for that particular previous year. What will be the correct answer in this case? That was a question. So first option, purchase consideration minus the depreciation claimed by the amalgamated company. Second option, so you answer me either one or two. Second option is the purchase consideration, the WDV of the amalgamating company minus the depreciation availed, minus the depreciation which is availed by the amalgamated company. Which is the two things? First option or the second option? So, Nishank, how come you are giving a conflicting view? Back to back, you have given a conflicting view. DSB High Performance. Yes, DSB. Students, let's have a look. Only this actual cost table, many students get frightened by this table. Don't worry, students. Only two or three things you will remember. Two or three things that should be known to you, and that should be all. Which are those two or three things which I want you to remember from this table? Let me give you the build up. Students, here which has been given to you, can you see this explanation number 7? What it has said: transfer of a capital asset in a scheme of an amalgamation by the amalgamating company to the amalgamated Indian company. Please understand, the amalgamated company, students, should be an Indian company. Amalgamated company should be an Indian company. So if that is the condition, if it is getting fulfilled, then it is a WDV of the amalgamating company. Students, it is the WDV of the amalgamating company that will be there. So if the buying company, amalgamated company, if the receiving company is an Indian company, then it will always be the WDV of the amalgamating company. So this is what would be the WDV. So accordingly, my second option was what? 1st April 2020 for the amalgamated company, the WDV, the open WDV in respect of those assets which it has received from on account of the amalgamation shall be the WDV of the amalgamating company minus the depreciation which the amalgamated company has claimed in the year of amalgamation. That is the answer of my last question which we did in the previous segment. Students, now I will just tick mark primarily here in some important point. This 7A and students, this one. Students, 4A. And one, two, 4A. And explanation number 7. So just tick whatever I have done the circle, students. These are the one which are very important for your IPCC examination. So what is the actual cost? What is the relevance of this actual cost concept that we are learning right now? The relevance of the actual cost, students, is because we have seen the format of the block as per which the asset will enter into the block. The asset will enter into the block on the basis of the actual cost of the asset. On the basis of what, students? On the basis of the actual cost of the asset. So accordingly, students, to know the actual cost of the asset, that this concept is relevant. The concept of the various explanation to section 43(1) is important, because in these cases what shall be the actual cost has been defined. So let's take up one by one. First one, students, asset acquired for scientific research brought for business use. First point, explanation number one. This is my next section, student, section 35. In the big deduction, section 35 is there. So over there, if the asset has been acquired for scientific research purpose, if the asset has been acquired for the scientific research purpose, students, what will happen would be, you are going to learn that the SSE is eligible for a full deduction under section 35. The SSE is eligible for full deduction under section 35. And the fact that it is eligible for a full deduction under section 35, what will happen? In this case, the actual cost would be the actual cost minus the deduction taken. Deduction taken in section 35. And that would be, if you have taken a full deduction will be reduced. So your actual cost will become nil. So the value at which it will enter into the block, the value at which it will enter into the block would be nil. Some students will say, sir, if it is to be nil, then what is the use? Better we don't add anything at all. If it is nil, then what is the use at all? Better we don't add anything at all. So is it the case, students? If it is nil, then we will just simply ignore, or we still consider, Priyanka, we'll still consider this nil value also in our block. Shall we still consider this nil value also in our block? This is my question to all of you. Shall we show in our presentation in the answer that add additions on actual cost and in the value side nil? Shall we show this presentation or not? Pratmanath, shall we show this presentation or not? And or we'll ignore just because the value has become nil. So let's ignore it. What will be the correct treatment, students? Quickly. Fairy, update of CA. Chandana, Trinath, yes, as you all are suggesting, students. Priya, Nishank, Priyanka, we have to show, because what is the scenario? Because there is a count of an asset which is included in the block. There is a count of an asset which is getting included in the block, and the fact that the asset count is getting increased in the block, we need to show them. And yes, as you all are suggesting, students, we will have to show the count of the asset in the block. Very good, students. Indeed. So the nil value, but the count would be there. Nil value, but the count would be there. Coming to point number two, students, asset acquired by way of gift or inheritance. Students, from father, I am receiving the asset as a gift. In the capital gains topic, students, our next topic in our capital gains, you will see that there is one section 47. There is one section 47 which says that in certain cases, which says what? In certain cases, the transfer will not be considered as a taxable transfer. There is one section 47 which says that the transfer will not consider as a taxable transfer. And because it is not a taxable transfer, therefore no capital gains will be arised. Because it is not a taxable transfer, no capital gains will be arised. That is what is the provision so far as section 47 is concerned. Fine, students. Now, be careful. In this case, transferor will therefore be not subject to any capital gains tax. Transferee has received the asset. So when the transferee, when it will subsequently will transfer that capital asset, then therefore it will be liable for the chargeability of the capital gains, and in computing the capital gains, the cost in the hands of this subsequent owner, the cost in the hands of this subsequent owner will be the cost of the previous owner. Why we go backward? Why we go backward to the cost of the previous owner? Because previous owner has not paid any capital gains tax. Previous owner has not paid any capital gains tax, and therefore the cost to the previous owner is what needs to be considered while computing the capital gains. So it is something like this, students. It is something like this. Herein, so father has acquired the asset at rupees 100. Okay. So the son has inherited the asset. Inherited the asset. At this date, the fair market value was rupees 130. Now, subsequently, the son has transferred the asset. Has transferred the asset, and at this stage, the selling price was rupees 200. Now, when the son here would be liable for capital gains calculation, the full value of consideration would be the selling price, and the cost here we take this as what? As the cost of the previous owner. The cost of the previous owner. The period of holding and all, I'll discuss with you in the next topic, that is of capital gains, long term, short term and all this I'll do discuss with you this thing. But the short point, students, here is that why we take the cost to the previous owner? For the reason being, the previous owner in this case was not subject to. So here there was section 47. Because of section 47, so section 47 was applicable, and the transfer was not considered. Was not considered as a taxable transfer. Was not considered as a taxable transfer. Okay, students. So that is the reason why. Yes, update. Yes, herein it will be there. That's the reason why the cost has been taken as a previous owner, so as to ensure that what was not taxed earlier in the hands of the previous owner is getting taxed in the hands of the subsequent owner. The cost to the previous owner is taken for the reason being just to ensure that what was not taxed earlier in the hands of the previous owner is getting taxed now in the hands of the subsequent owner. Did you all got this one, students? Shall we proceed further quickly? Students, I'll tell you one thing and you can just consider this. Today, in fact, Priya, she was in touch, so she would have known. I made this three attempt, and I'm actually taking the lectures I'm taking throughout the day, but I was doing only recording. I was not live, so I was just doing a recording part. And then evening, because I was being told that by 4 o'clock we will get your network ready, the alternate network. I made a three attempt. By the time three attempt was happened, the frustration came up. Then thought of, let us give one more try. If what will happen at this, let's see. But mine already got disturbed. Why it got disturbed? Because yesterday also could not take because of this issue, and today also. So mine was already disturbed. It got irritated and all. And therefore, like, let's do one more time. And at that point of time, it is on. My only says, these are small events which is worth learning, students. When there is a failure that you witness in life, you feel very frustrated, irritated. But it is always very important as to whether in that irritation, whether you go for the second plunge or not. Because that is very, very important, students. That is where, when the chips are down, see, when you have to start, and I have to start, I was very much energetic. But two times, three times, it is not happening. Then at that time, you are getting irritated. And then again, whether you are going or not, this is where, students, I am telling you that whenever you are practicing also, if you are not getting hold of something, and you're getting frustrated on that process, don't give it up. This is just testing you that on the difficult day, when the things are not happening the way you want it to happen, what you do, whether you still push, whether you still pursue, or you simply give it up. This is what truants, a CA degree is all about. CA degree is not about taxation and costing. These things will only help you at one stage of your life. But if you really want to grow big, make your own name, get name, fame, and make an identity and mark in life, this is what is required. Degree will help you only till one point of time in your life. Beyond that, it's your character that is going to sail you through. Keep in mind, these are my words, and I'm making it, that's the thing, you will count it, not right now, 5 years down the line, after you become CA. What helps you to get the further success is these things. So you start building your patience, you start building your character at this age when the tree is growing. in the profession. At that stage, you need to build the character. Not that when I'm fully grown, and then at that stage, you want to build up on the roots, it is not going to happen. Keep this one in mind, because that is what I learned it. Had it, I would given up. Four times, like, forget it now. I'll do it tomorrow. It was very easy for me to just announce it in the Telegram channel that, okay, now tomorrow. Okay, and that's it. But you just need to stick your neck, students. And that is one thing which I'll, which always will say to you, all of you. So students, in this case, coming back, RV Prasad, this means PGPP is applied on this part. Yes, PGPP. Not PGPP. RV Prasad by PGPP. You'll say RV Prasad is asking, sir, what is the relevance of PGPP on this part? RV Prasad, the relevance of PGPP of this part is that if supposedly this is a depreciable asset, the son may be doing the business from the asset that it has inherited from his father. From the asset that he has inherited from his father, the son may do the business from that particular asset. The son may do the business from that particular asset. Then students, in respect of that asset, you will be eligible to claim the depreciation. So depreciation, RV Prasad, will be in respect of what amount? The depreciation will then be in respect of this rupees 100. Depreciation will be in respect of what amount? It will be in respect of this rupees 100. Did you all got this one, students? Fine. Now then, let me take it further, our discussion, quickly. Coming back to our charts. So now I will be dealing with the last area, which is there. Explanation number 4A now, students. This is very important. What it has said? Asset acquired by an SSE from another person. Students, from another person. And that asset is leased back to such other person. Leave it for the time being. Students, one of the point, tell me first that particular thing. I'm asking you a question. Ownership was a criteria for the purpose of the claim of the depreciation. That is what we have said. Ownership is a precondition for the purpose of the claim of the depreciation, is what we have all discussed, isn't it? So in the context of the ownership, students, in the context of the ownership, I have given you two special point. And in that two special point, one was, in the case of the higher purchase, it is the higher purchaser who will claim the depreciation. And in the case of the lease, be it finance lease or be it the operating lease, be it the finance lease or be it the operating lease, but if it is the case of a lease, it is the lessee or the lesser who will be the one who will be claiming the depreciation. That was my question to all of you. Ashwini, Chandana, whether it would be the lesser or lessee, who will be the one who will be claiming the depreciation in this case? And what I have made you write, update for CA. No, it is not the lessee, PA Priyanka. It is the lesser which I have made you all write. See your notebook. There I have made you all write that the lesser will be the one who will claim the depreciation so far as the Income Tax Act is concerned. Whether that lease is a finance lease, whether that lease is an operating lease. Okay. So keep that particular point in mind. Don't make the mistake. Now, coming to this explanation number 4A, what it says? It says that asset acquired by an SSE from another person, and that asset is leased back to such other person. So what will be the answer? The WDV of the asset to the transferor at the time of transfer to the SSE. Students, please pay attention to this one. Mr. A, Mr. B. Okay. Now he is the transferor. Okay. Transferor and then lessee. Fine. And he is lesser. Buyer. Or you can say transferee and lesser. Sale, lease back. Explanation 4A to section 43(1). So, we all know, students. So, we all know what is this arrangement. What is this arrangement? This arrangement, students, as per this, Mr. A has sold the goods to Mr. B. Say, for example, Mr. B says that, look, Mr. A, I want to claim some depreciations. I want to reduce my profit and loss, profit and gains. Kindly assist me to help me to reduce my profit and gains. Mr. B is requesting to whom? To Mr. A. Now, accordingly, Mr. A is obliging. How Mr. A is obliging to Mr. B? He says that, fair enough. I have got one asset whose WDV is 20, but I will sell it to you in the books at 200 rupees between both of us. I'm selling it to you at what rupees? 200 rupees. Now, Mr. B happens to be my brother only, or my relative kind of a person. So that Mr. B, when he will take it in the books, he will be in a, it will give an impression that Mr. B will be claiming the depreciation on rupees 200. Now, please be careful, students. Mr. B is the owner now. Mr. B, being the lesser, shall be the owner and eligible for what, students? Eligible for depreciation. Okay, but on what value is the golden question? But on what value, students? But on what value? So now, as per 200 rupees, what at the price at which Mr. B has received from Mr. A, or the WDV of Mr. A, which is 20? So what will be the answer in this case? Will it be at rupees 200, the price at which Mr. B has received from Mr. A, or at rupees 20, that is the WDV of Mr. A at the time of transfer? It is the WDV of Mr. A. Perfect. WDV of Mr. A, who is a transferor. Yes, students, at the time of transfer to Mr. B. Indeed, students, very good. WDV of Mr. A, transfer at the time of transfer to Mr. B. Indeed, it will be at rupees 20. Did you all got this one? Shall you proceed? So, with this one now, students, all the concept of the actual cost, that much only is required, students. Whatever I have done in the circular, what is the actual cost? That is what you need to capture. So, students, now then, here the cost to the previous owner, yes, you can say. Previous owner means the WDV of the transferor. The perfect wording would be the WDV to the transferor. Students, now therefore, as I told you, the biggest section of your entire income tax was depreciation. How you are going to revise the depreciation? The way I have given it to you. Students, how you are going to revise the depreciation? The way we have discussed. All together, I have already given you the chart. You have captured this chart, this 32. Basis of depreciation, conditions for depreciation. Basis, you all know, SLM, I told you, MCQ. One question, most sufficient for MCQ. Eligible asset. Block method. In block method, students, you have seen how the block formatting was done. Some permutation and combination I have given to you. Whether short-term capital gains or whether depreciation will be eligible. Some permutation combination I have given it to you. Keep that in mind. After that, students, conditions. In that condition, we have seen ownership. Remember that thing. The person who possession, use, and entitled to hold. Three words: possession, use, and entitled to hold. This was the three terms which I told you to remember for the purpose of ownership. Title owner, not relevant. Beneficial owner, relevant. That is how you're supposed to remember it. Eligible assets and the rate, students. We have seen the block. Intangible asset, we know 25%. Tangible asset, three categories. Which are those three categories? Which is furniture, building, and plant and machinery. And in the plant and machinery, there are various subcategories. So, students, for you, this is very important. This part is very important, students. Yes, Priyanka. This part is very, very important. You have to be very careful about this one. The rate. Plant and machinery, how you will prepare the block? The asset falling in the class, the asset which the class of the asset which are eligible to the same rate of depreciation in that subcategory. Which subcategory? Plant. So the class of the asset which is subject to the same rate of depreciation in that subcategory, in respect of those class you will prepare one single block. In respect of those class you will prepare what, students? A single block. And that is what we have also practiced, how to prepare the block, isn't it? So keep that example in mind. It's very important. Plus, students, the amendment part, motor car, especially the motor car which is acquired from August 23rd to 31st March and installed before, on or before 31st March. Because then the rate increases by 15% in both the categories. Which are those two categories? Category number one, when the asset motor car is not used for the business of running them on hire. And the second category was when the motor car is used in the business of running them on hire. So therefore, in that particular context, students, I have told you and I have taught you this particular part. So you should always be careful about this part because this is very important for your examination. Apportionment of depreciation, students, the last part, point number 5 that we did earlier. This can come as a 3-4 to 5 marks question. It can come, yes. Because there would be a calculation that will be involved. Or students, maybe it can also come for, MCQ. Even that is the chances for the apportionment of depreciation. Concept is simple, so I don't think that is much technical. And the last one, actual cost, students, you'll do that 4 points which we have discussed. The 4 points, students, that we have discussed. And yes, Sai Shirdi Limited, some ferry, perfect. So this is one thing that we are supposed to deal with it. I hope that all of you have got hold with this point. And with that now, students, we will proceed to our next big deduction. So in the big deduction, 32 is done. Now then, actually, these are not big deduction. They are small deduction only, but I have captured it over here only. Okay. So let's try to do now 35, students. Scientific research asset. Student, section 35. Donation. The section 35. Very important section, students. Section 35 and 35AD. Let's get started with this. All of you in your chart. And students, after 35AD, I will like to do with you, maybe definitely not today, but tomorrow I'll do with you 10AA. Because after 35AD, you will find section 10AA very relevant. 10AA, are you aware? It is there in your syllables. And 10AA also I will do, and I will do immediately AMT. And then I will do small deductions of PGAP. Are you aware? AMT is there in your syllables. Are you aware or not? Alternate minimum tax. Alternate minimum tax. AMT is there as a part of your syllables. Are you aware of that? Ashwini? SEZ, yes. 10AA is SEZ. Yeah, 10AA and alternate minimum tax, students, AMT. Alternate minimum tax, AMT. No, not minimum alternate tax. It is alternate minimum tax. Minimum alternate tax is there in final CA. In IPCC, I'm talking about it. Alternate minimum tax. Yes, Priya. So, students, herein, now 33AB, students, this you can delete it. This is not there in your syllables. This only part you can delete it. 33AB, not a part of your syllables. This will learn, students, in final CA. Now, coming to this particular part, this section 35. section 25, which is in respect of the scientific research essay students. Now, there are two parts. Can you see this? I will say to be students part B. I'll say this to be what? Part B. And this, I'll say this to be a part A. Students, why this I'm making a distinction? Because very unique section it is, section 35. It actually tackles both. And what is it? Both the things? That is to say, students, supposing I'm a CA in practice. I'm getting a professional income. I'm a CA in practice and I'm getting what? A professional income. And that particular professional income which I'm having. So students, here if I'm, say for example, I'm giving a donation to IIT. I'm giving a donation to IIT. Now, for a CA in practice getting a professional income, I have got no such relationship with IIT. But I'm giving the donation to IIT for the purpose of the research program. So what will happen, while I will compute my professional income, under section 35, I will be eligible for 150% deduction, students. I will be eligible for what? 150% deduction. And that is really very great and phenomenal thing. So please understand, this is a very unrelated area. But even if it is unrelated, still I will get the deduction of 150% on the contribution which I have made to the IIT. The only requirement is that I should have a business income. I should have what, students? A business income. Because a person who is earning a salary income, whether they can think of getting a deduction under section 35, and the answer is no, because they will not be under the head salary. The fact that these particular person will not be under the head salary, PGBP, therefore the question of deduction under section 35 will not arise. So the only requirement to get the deduction in part A is two things. Number one, the SSC should have a business or a professional income chargeable under this head. And number two, he should have made the donation to the specified institution. Then irrespective of whether these particular institution, these particular donation is related to the SSC's business or not, irrespective of whether these donations are related to the SSC business or not, the SSC will be eligible for the deduction under section 35. The SSC will be eligible for the deduction under section 35. That exactly how it would be considered. Yes, Priyanka is right. That 150% that we can see, I have already written in the red bold remark. So this, can you see the last line which is there? 100% from previous year 2021. But for all of you, for November 2020 examination students, for all of you, you have what? The previous year 1920. And because you all have previous year 1920, for those appearing in November 20, they will have only 100%. For those who are appearing, they will have 150% wherever it is. But those who appear for May 21, November 21, for these students, it will become what? All the section, in all section 35, it will be 100% only. So wherever 150% is written, for May 21, November 21 students, it will become 100%. Now let's have a look quickly to part A. Let's have a quick look to part A. Contribution to the association. I'll read that particular part first. Now here, students, just focus on B and the 150% category. Students, focus on the 150% category. And what is that 150% category? Primarily, the 150% category is, 100% is about the herein. It is 100%. 35-2, 150%, and 35-2AA is 150%. Students, you have been asking me one question earlier that, sir, whether we are supposed to remember the section numbers also. What I've told you, not required, but at least for one particular section, one particular area of your income tax, please remember the section number, also the clause number, and that is this section. Because in the examination, students, it has been seen that ICI have, in some of the question which I've seen of interest CA, these people are asking like donation given to the institute eligible for deduction under section 35(2)(AA), like that. 35(2)(AA), this is what I have seen. Now, students, in this regard, if the donation has been given, then what has been debited is only 100. Because please understand one thing, students, in accountancy, if you are doing an expenditure of rupees 100, then the debit would also be of rupees 100. Then the debit also would be of rupees 100. But in the income tax law, here, as far as section 35(2)(AA) or section 35(1)(2) is concerned, if you make a donation of 100, then you get a deduction of 150%. You get a deduction of how much? 150%. So what will happen, students, would be, didn't I told you, when you compute a PGBP, students, when you are computing a PGBP, from the base amount, you are doing the adjustment. This is what I taught you in the computational part first, that PGBP head, from the base amount, you will do the adjustment. CG and house property head, there is no base amount. Right from the first value till the last value, you have to do the entire computation for the head PGB, for the head house property, and for the head capital gains. But when it comes to the head PGBP, there is already a base value on which you have to do the further adjustments. There is already a base value on which you are supposed to do a further adjustments. That is what I have taught you, isn't it? And therefore, in your base value, what is that base value? The base value, students, is the accounting profit. The base value is the accounting profit, and that accounting profit, on that you will do the adjustment of the section 28 to section 43B. Now, please understand, in accounting, when you do the expenditure of 100, this is what I have told you, when you do the expenditure of rupees 100, you will debit also rupees 100. You will debit also rupees 100. That is what you will all do. If you do the expenditure of rupees 100, then you will also debit rupees 100. That is what you do. But income tax allows you 150%. So what you are going to do to get the PGBP, what is the treatment that you will do? You will do the extra deduction of rupees 50. You will do an extra deduction of rupees 50, students. So whatever is the profit which has been shown in the accounting purpose, on that profit, you will give an extra deduction of 50. You'll say, sir, why not 150? Why not 150? Because while arriving at the accounting profit, you already have debited 100. So therefore, what is now required further for the purpose of arriving at the income tax profit? What is now required further for the purpose of arriving at the income tax profit is to get an extra deduction of rupees 50. To get the extra deduction of rupees 50 is what is required at this point of time. So this is what, students, you will do it in the examination. Be careful. And there are certain practical questions which we are going to touch upon in our discussion. Yeah, 50 extra 50 deduction we will now give. Now, students, one last question which has been there, which is this. Can you see this black shade which has been there? Very important point, students. Students, this particular point. Students, this is also an important aspect. See what happens, students. These institutions, government keep on monitoring the activity of these institutions. And the moment they find that this activity is no longer meant for the purpose for which it got certified, what they do? They will denotify these institutions. They will take out the approval. They will denotify, or they will take out the approval from all these institutions. The moment the government comes to know that these institutions no longer serve for the purpose for which they have been created. Now, the problem for a SSC like me, for example, students, in the previous year 1920, I have a professional income, as I told you. I have given the donation to the institution. At that time, when the donation was being given, the institution was already notified. However, subsequently, subsequently what happens? Subsequently, you can say that the institution became denotified. Subsequently, that institution students became denotified. When it became denotified? Say maybe before the filing of the return of income. So for previous year 1920, say I'm going to file my return of income in 30th November. So before I could file the return of income, the institution got denotified by the central government. My question therefore to all of you would be that whether while I file my return of income, will I still be eligible to get the deduction under section 139(1)? Will I still be getting the deduction primarily of this donation under section 35? And the answer is yes. You shall still be eligible to claim the deduction for the reason being, yes students, for the reason being, what is to be seen is that at the time of giving the donation, whether that institute was it notified or not. If it was notified at the time of donation, then whatever happens to it later on has no relevance. The SSC shall be eligible to claim the deduction of this donation or the contribution given to this institution. Did you all got this? This is students one point which I feel could be targeted in the examination. This is one point, students. Just be ready about this particular part. Okay, with this one now, we are into the part B. Students, part B. If you see part B, students, the in-house expenditure. Now, what is this in-house expenditure? Research, students, specifically for the manufacturing companies. Manufacturing company, students. For these companies, research is an ongoing process. Many companies does research. Pharmaceutical companies. Even a normal manufacturing company, all your motor cars, you see your Honda City, a Honda City car of 2002 model versus a Honda City car of model 2020, a huge difference in terms of its size, in terms of the fuel emissions, the technological innovations, the other comfort, whatever it be, you will find a huge difference of a 2002 Honda City model versus a 2020 Honda City model. What is happening? How the change has occurred? Because of the continuous process of the research which is going on. And therefore, students, for these in-house research expenditure which the SSC undertakes, for those particular research expenditure, that section 35 allows you the deduction. Now, if you see over here, the best part of this deduction, students, the best part of this deduction is what? That in the research program, if the expenditure which is capital in nature, students, if the expenditure which is capital in nature, if that is also incurred, still you will be getting a deduction. Still you shall be getting a deduction of that capital expenditure. So the best part now, students, we are going to enter it at this stage. Section 35 and the next section 35 AD and the next two section 35CCC and 35CCD. In these sections, we will be getting the deduction of what? A capital expenditure. Which, please pay attention, which as per the rules of accountancy, students, as per the rules of accountancy, do you get deduction of a capital expenditure? And the answer is no. So do you know what would have happened? The base figure for PGBP, which I have taught you, which is the accounting profit for business. In that accounting profit for business, you would not have debited the capital expenditure. On the contrary, what would have been debited, students, would have been the depreciation amount on these capital expenditure. So that is what would have been debited in determining what? In determining the net profit. However, when it comes to the income tax law, what the income tax law says? That it says that if you are doing a research, we are going to give you the incentive, and the incentive would be in the form of a full deduction of the expenditure. A full deduction of what runs? Of the expenditure. Even though the expenditure may be capital in nature. So accounting says depreciation. Income tax says what? Income tax says full deduction in respect of the capital expenditure. So can you tell me how the treatment would be done? How the treatment would be done? So if students, you have already debited the depreciation in determining the accounting income, which is considered as the base for the further adjustment of the head PGVP from section 28 to section 43B, then that depreciation which has been debited has to be added back, and you are going to reduce a full capital expenditure that you have incurred in respect of the items which are mentioned in the section 35, 35AD, 35CCC and 35CCD. 35, 35AD, 35CCC and 35CCD, the four section. In the four section, you will find that the capital expenditure is allowed to you as a deduction, students. Did you all got this one? All of you? Yes, Pramnath. Priyanka? Say, students, fast, quickly. R.V. Prasad is saying, can we avail both section 32 and section 35? And the answer is no. Double deduction, R.V. Prasad, not allowed. Double deduction is not allowed. You will see if you are in 35 and 35AD. If you are in 35 or you are in 35AD. So in that case, students, in that case, the capital expenditure, you are taking a full deduction. You are taking a full deduction of the capital expenditure. So where is the question of claiming? Where is the question of claiming the deduction of these particular expenditure? Isn't it? Do you not get the depreciation now? Once you claim a full deduction of the capital expenditure, now forget the claim of depreciation. It cannot happen that I give you on one hand the deduction of the capital expenditure, and on the other hand, I'm also giving you what? This one. It will never happen that you get both the benefit. So I was telling you, students, this one, this particular part, the competition part. Remember that this 5A, I think the chart you have prepared already, I think fourth or fifth, like fourth lecture or so, I have given you this chart. So you have prepared this chart. And when you see in the PGBP, that star mark, net, there's a base value, which is a net profit as per books for business, accounting books. So in accounting books, for a capital expenditure, you don't do a P&L debit. You don't do a P&L debit. So at the most, the depreciation would have been debited. At the most, the depreciation would have been debited. So what I'm supposed to do? What sort of an adjustment then would be required? The adjustment then would be required would be, say, section 35 or section 35AD. I will claim a full deduction of the expenditure. I will claim a full deduction of an expenditure. Now you will say that, sir, you are claiming a full deduction of the expenditure of the capital nature, but you already have debited the depreciation as well. So 100% here, full deduction, and then depreciation also. So what you will do, that depreciation that you have taken, that you will add it back. That you will add it back. And you will ensure to give a full deduction of the capital expenditure. Now students, primarily, because this is a critical section, I will have to put a pause on this one. I want all of you now that 35, this part B, 35AD, this 35 and 35AD, these two sections I want all of you to read and come. these two sections I want all of you to read and come, because I think now SFM lecture also, FM lecture, Chinmay sir will be now conducting in some time from now. So he will also will be logging in the same ID. So I think from today's lecture, there was no network issue, isn't it? It all went well. So we will be good if tomorrow everything goes well. So tomorrow also, we, if suppose some technical snag happens, so I will be in a position to connect with you through this particular medium. Yes, Dishang, but I think we have to exit, and then it takes some time in processing, and then he will have to enter. So even that takes some time, while he will also go up live. So I need to close it before time. Today, say students, now just ensure students one homework. What is the reading that you will do? Your students, please ensure tomorrow morning itself, I'll quickly wrap it up. And tomorrow target is 35 AD. What is the next one? Third one, I will be doing 10AA. And finally, fourth one, AMT. Finally, fourth one would be AMT. Four things for tomorrow session. And we will not look into the time. We will have to complete that much. 35 AD, 10AA, and AMT. Four things, students, together will try to solve it. Okay? So, see you then tomorrow session, students. In four particular, this thing, tomorrow would be a critical session, because we have to cover up these four concepts for the tomorrow's class. Fine? After that, I will do with you small deductions. Quickly, I will do a small deductions. Not much of time would be required. Disallowance, small deduction, students, which are there in PGVP, I don't think students fear the small deduction. The fear of the students are this area, which I'm doing it presently. And that is the reason why we will have to get a firm base, including the practicals. And then small deductions, we'll try to finish it off fast. Books of accounts, tax audit, 44AA, 44AB, chapter over, capital gains. Fine, students. So my target is that by second or third, primarily, second or third, we should be now switching over to CG. Because once CG is over, rest of the topics are very small. House property, IFOs, salary, chapter 6A, and salary, chapter 6A. Yeah, these are the two topics which has got numbers into it. You have to by heart the numbers in salary and chapter 6A. So that is the only area which I want to do it towards the end, because of the number crunching by hearting exercise. Okay, so that is the only two topics which I will try to deal with the end. And I mean, I can say that I would have then completed your syllables. TDS and all are like one session. I'll just do it quickly and I'll wrap it up. Okay, students, the important sections on TDS and all, I'll do the last slide, which you can see the important area of TDS. I'll do it, because obviously it will come in the examination. So we cannot leave it. We will do it, but the important ones I'll do it, so that you know all the critical areas of the same. Fine, students, keep revising, but just do the homework. Tomorrow, I have already told you, 35 AD, 10AA, and AMT. If you have any queries, then you please do let me know in the tomorrow's class. Okay, I'm just closing up now. See you then tomorrow. Thank you very much, students. Thank you.